New tonight, it's been a deadly month on Iowa interstates. So how can you stay safe behind the wheel? News Channel 8's Eric Hansen looks to law enforcement for some life-saving advice.
Stephen, several of the recent crashes, cars have crossed the median and hit oncoming traffic. In another, a tire may have blown, causing a collision. Regardless of fault, troopers say the key is driving defensively, preparing for anything.
When 8 people die in just 10 days in the same part of the state, even the experts wonder, what's going on?
This is up there, though. This one's pretty bad.
The victims in these crashes had milliseconds to react, which is why state troopers say speed and following distances are key.
Driving 55 miles an hour, it takes you 3/4 of a second to react from your gas pedal to your brake pedal, and then it takes your vehicle in that 55 mile an hour zone 163 feet to complete an entire stop.
Half a football field when you stomp on the brakes. So give yourself the best chance of surviving by looking way down the road.
Focusing ahead of yourself, looking, you know, 4 and 5 seconds ahead, 10 seconds ahead about what's, you know, going to occur in front of you.
But what if it's your tire that suddenly blows?
I see that happen quite frequently.
And just as frequently, drivers overreact. Instincts say stop quickly, but this safety video shows why blown tires can become deadly when you hit the brakes. A car that loses a tire and stops quickly will wipe out. Instead, when you feel a tire blow, safety experts say take your foot off the accelerator, keep driving straight, and let your car coast before eventually easing out of traffic.
Also, try to avoid overcorrecting during your braking pattern, because if you overcorrect and steer too hard in a braking situation, your vehicle's going to lose control.
It's all motion, mechanics, and timing, but troopers say it's also about giving yourself every opportunity to react when milliseconds count.
The majority of Iowa's accidents on Iowa's roadways are preventable accidents.
And investigators don't yet know if distractions contributed to any of the crashes, but they are seeing more and more that do over the years. And when you only have a fraction of a second to react, even a quick glance at a cell phone or to the radio can add a lot of stopping distance to the problem, which is why they plead keep your hands on the wheel and your eyes on the road.
Good advice. Thank you, Eric.